So let's talk about my drought tolerant garden as a whole. The reason that I emphasize on drought tolerant flowers in my garden here is because I have no access to a hose or water. So whatever goes in the garden has to be able to withstand whatever nature is going to give it. Hi guys, welcome to my Tennessee drought tolerant garden review. It's November. Let's see what surprises we can find. I also have some new garden tools to use today, and I'm pretty excited about that. Today's video is sponsored by Group Pow. We have their premium garden shears to test out today, and we also have their garden knife, so let's go get these guys dirty. I wanted to take a second and draw attention to these roses here. For the most part, these roses have been neglected as long as I've lived here, which has been about 5 years now. This is the first year that I've cut them back. This is November 3rd, and it's still getting buds on it. I just couldn't cut them back. I gave a hard cut to wherever there was no buds blooming yet. But look, we still have one here. I let this guy go. Look at this branch here. It's still blooming. I think it's absolutely gorgeous for that reason. So it's looking a little spindly now, but it's still blooming. And we have one over there that I didn't trim, and I don't know why I didn't walk that far, but I didn't. But I had to point it out that this guy is still going. So I didn't take it all the way down because eventually I want to bring him down. So it's about 2 foot tall, and see how he really, you know, spreads next year when he's not all tall and lanky when he gets a good heart prune. But that's my rose story for you.
done all that I'm going to do. I thought that I had a lot more work out here necessary, but as I am looking over everything, there is still so much really color and green. There's the only brown in my garden really at this point is the leaves that are falling. The hostas are looking a little bit weak, you know, but I can't bear myself to chop down, especially like the autumn joys here. And look at these salvias. They're doing outstanding. And the purple hearts, I can't take those down. Not when they're still blooming. And even the roses are still blooming down here. So my autumn cleanup, you know, I thought was going to be complete today, but obviously it's not. So maybe it'll be December when I do this. I thought it was going to be my last video as far as my outdoor work goes. But, you know, I'm not necessarily disappointed to come out here again. So let's talk about my drought-tolerant garden as a whole. The reason that I emphasize on drought-tolerant flowers in my garden here is because I have no access to a hose or water. So whatever goes in the garden has to be able to withstand whatever nature is going to give it. And this year we had probably about 3 months of drought with just a random one-day rain here and there. I'd be surprised if we've had five overall. On a whole, I'm really pleased the way that the garden turned out. Most of my flowers did really well. I think the ones that did the least well were my black-eyed Susans. They really struggled, you know, but my God, if I was doing a whole garden with one flower, it would be these salvias. These guys are not, they don't quit. You know, the salvias, the sedum, and the purple hearts, and the Mexican petunias, they've been outstanding. This is November, they're still blooming. I thought I was gonna come out here and whine about the end of my garden because I cried all, you know, my mom had to listen to me whine about the lack of water and what my garden looked like. And as I sit here and look at it in the background, it really looks pretty impressive, I think, for November. As far as a year-end video goes, I'm pretty pleased with what my garden ended up doing and how well it did do. If the only plant I was gonna lose was the black-eyed Susans, and maybe they're not dead because we did see some leaves coming up, so maybe next year they'll be more solid in the ground and they can take it better. I want to thank you again to my sponsor, Group Pow. I got to test out their digger here, their garden knife. This is the first time I've ever used a garden knife for weeding because I've always just used my shovel. I found this so much easier. This was a first time use and I'm so glad I have this now. I have tried many clippers and shears throughout the years, and these are really solid. They have a nice weight. The mechanism is very clean and smooth. So I was really pleased with the way these guys were working too. So, you know, good day in the garden, good day with the tools in the hands. Thanks again for watching my video today, guys. Catch you in the next one. Toodles.